Good morning, fellow option traders. This is Jeff, and welcome to the daily scan for Friday the 13th. This is June, and we're going to be, I don't know, is this a good day or not? But anyway, we'll find out. Looking at the news from yesterday, it was kind of mixed. The jobless claims was a little up from, so that's not good, sort of a grayish news, and retail sales was sort of good news, up a tad. Import and export prices pretty flat. Business inventories are rising, but so are sales. So I guess it's kind of a wash there. So where are we? We don't know where we are right now. For today, we have producer price index and consumer sentiment. All either before the market opens or soon after. Okay, let's take a look across the ponds over in Asia. Sort of mixed, but mostly positive. And in Europe, we are red across the board. Alright, so there is some stuff going on around the world that is troubling. And they say here, this isn't the start of a sell-off, but it's coming. I don't know how anybody can say that. Either way, probably a correction is coming. Don't know when, but there's always a correction. Here we saw one in April, but an even stronger one that burned me pretty good in February. Sort of unexpected when I definitely had a very bullish bias at that time, trying to squeeze money out of a turnip. And in April, there is a little bit of one also, not as strong as the one in February. But this one's looking pretty good right here. And if we were to look at the futures here in the U.S., which we'll do right now, we can see that we're looking, this is 10 down from the open, but the open gapped. We'll take a peek at the ES chart. Oops, it's coming here. There it is. Okay, so look at this. We gap down. Now it's down 10 for the day, but it's down, where are we here? 1931 down to 1923. So that's 8 points there alone, which is a pretty strong gap down. Doesn't usually, well, I don't know if it's because of the new quarter, the new futures contracts cycle. This cycle ended, this is the beginning of a new cycle, although a lot of people have already transferred their, if they're holding them, their futures from this quarter into this quarter. And anyway, it's neither here nor there. It's where this is visually that could be a sign of not a correction per se, but definitely a pullback. So we're looking at 13 for the Dow, down 13 or 14. And we're down about, you know, where are we here? Like, not a whole lot percentage wise. But let's take a look at gold and oil. Gold is up to 1273 and oil is at 107.01. All pretty hefty numbers there. Okay, for yesterday, a little bit of whiplash on Priceline. I went one direction, then I went the other direction later on in the day. And at 3:30 when I came here and looked at everything, it looked like as though I could pile on some negative delta, which is exactly what I did. I jumped into Amazon and Boeing with some negative delta here, Google, and I reversed price line. I was positive delta. Looked really good in the morning. We'll take a look at that chart. I got in just a tad early. If I would have followed my rules and waited until 10 o'clock, it would have been a different story, but I didn't. I wanted to catch it early. So I got in about 10 minutes too early and paid the price. And I had to reverse it later in the day. And Russell, which we got in a couple days ago. Okay, let's switch over to the Analyze tab. And we'll go to the A-plus list and we'll see what's going on. Try to keep Friday a little bit shorter. Keep comments from the peanut gallery to a minimum. All right, Apple, could have gotten into it yesterday, probably should have, but I took a pass on it just because of the weird prices and stuff like that. I just didn't want to mess with it, I guess you could say. I don't know why that's keeping me out of it, but it is. So it didn't do anything there. We are in almost a setup situation here, but like I mentioned before, if this thing hooks back up, I'll probably will be jumping in on it, even though it didn't get down to the 30. But looking at the way it's going to open today, there's no way that I'm going with any sort of bullish trade on this at this time, just based on this price action pre-market. All right, Amazon. You can see, let's see, reset these and reset these so we get a good, honest picture here. We're in Amazon here. And we'll take a look at the chart. So we did a 20 delta on Amazon. I could have done probably more lots on that, but I didn't. So this looked pretty good. I think that, I don't know. Apparently the market didn't like their streaming audio announcement, I guess. I don't know, how is it different than, say, like iHeartRadio or one of those other services? I don't know. I don't know how it's different. But anyway, that's that. So we are in a uptrend, downtrend. I think we're going to hook down here. It looks like the 50 is going to be turning into a steeper downtrend. And I would expect the 20 to roll over quickly as well. Aftermarket, it held down there. So, you know, we'll just see how it works out. Take a look at Boeing. We are right at the money, basically, with Boeing right now. Looks like there's also some aftermarket. Yesterday trades moved it up a tad, but jumped in on this with a 50 delta trade. So basically an overnight trade, have to do something about it today. But this is a, I guess you could call this a definitely a trend reversal trade, taking a kind of a big chance on this after a very strong run up. But man, these are some huge moves. And I expect them to continue because overnight you can see that it kind of held its own and then during the day it just shot down. So we're keeping our fingers crossed on this one. Definitely maybe violated some rules on this. Okay, we have Baidu. I think I'm probably going to exit this today. Where are my shorts at? They're at 28 cents. I can still make another 28 cents on it. I'm not sure if it's going to be able to withstand the onslaught of the market. So if it starts to come down here, we'll be looking to get out today. So I made a note of it. I'll be watching it. CELG, we are down here in setup territory. Enough said about that. Chipotle. Remember, Friday is not my favorite trading day for 50 delta trades. Chipotle, very counter to the market yesterday. Very strong. That's pretty impressive, I have to say. But nothing there for us at this time. Costco. Very impressive move down. Looks a lot like Amazon. Not Amazon, but Boeing. So I don't know what's going on here with Costco. I'm removing this target. I'm just a little concerned about this. This is a very strong move. Pretty much linear. Yeah, I'm taking a pass on that. Chevron. Oil's going up, and so is Chevron. So we'll wait to see what happens with that. Peek at the Dow. Yes, pretty red. Igor. I think that this is oil exploration. Is that what they are? Anyway, this is a kind of a topping kind of a candle where it tried to move up during the day and then it fought a battle and it ended up pretty much where it opened. So that is sort of telling me that it may be at a top. But nothing there for us right now. FedEx was thinking about some stuff here. Let me get rid of that. Whoa! Holy mackerel. Wow, that's all I got to say. glad we got out of that one. It cost me a little bit because we did lose some money on this. But, oh wow. That's huge. It's a big move down, folks. Nothing there for us, though, at this time. F5 Networks. I had my alert on here. My alert still has not triggered. I'm assuming it's going to probably pull back a little bit here. Where are we at here? We're at $12 out of a possible 200. And we'll just be patient on it. We got a week. We'll see how it works out. Gold? How you doing, Gold? Gold had a nice day yesterday. We still need it up here around 125, 126 before we sell a call on it. Google. Got into it yesterday. How are we looking today? Oh man, we're like all over the place. We're up here, we're down here. So we're looking for $482. Maybe it, you know, if we get out this afternoon, if it's down somewhere near $400 on this, hopefully. LinkedIn. We're not in currently. LinkedIn counter to the market yesterday. That's a good, pretty good strong sign. I don't know what's going on with them though. Still not able to really figure it out. 3M. Oh, followed the market. Nice and orderly. This is in setup. So I'm going to say it's in setup. But whether it do anything about it or not, I don't know. Might do a 20 delta on it. If I trade today, I'm doing 20 deltas. And what's a 20 delta for expiration next week? What does that look like here? Let's see here, 20 delta. We're looking at 141 roughly. 141, which is down here. For next week's, you know, expire in here, will it stay above here? Who knows? But that's what I would do as a 20 delta. I'm going to trade that today. NDX, not as big of a move as S&P. Tech stocks, as we see, as we look down this list here, mostly, for the most part, a four-character symbol is a NASDAQ symbol. And we saw that a lot of those are running counter to the market. But not all, but a few. So they're kind of cropping up NDX here, which is the top 100 stocks in the NASDAQ, or at least a list of 100 stocks. I don't know if they're the top ones or not. But it's propping this up just a tad. So we're still waiting for an entry down here. Netflix. Nothing going on there. Flat. Don't know what to do with it either. But we're sort of watching for, you know, 50 delta on this. But I'm not feeling real confident about a 50 delta price line. We're a little bit in the money on this particular trade. So here we are in the morning. I got in just a tad bit too early. And the second half hour opened and wiggled around a little bit and then shot down. So that was not a good trade, and I took a pretty big hit on this just because the time is so short. And when it goes into money, man, it screams into the losing territory, as we can see by this. Actually, it was on the other trade, on the other side of this, the bull put trade. The white line was very steep. This one's a little bit more mellow, but it'll get steep today. And it could be just because it's overnight data. It's kind of static data. All right, the Russell. Here we are. What's going on here? Oh, okay. So the Russell, we're here. We're looking at almost 50% on this at this time. So this is 2 days into that trade. We're looking for a move down in it today as well. SPX, we're probably going to get an additional move down on this today. We are in setup territory for a bull put, but like I said, probably wouldn't do that, but I'm going to put it on my 20 delta list. Be very cautious, because we may be, I mean, the events in the world are sort of telling me that if the markets keep going up, that means they're happy. And I find that pretty hard to believe. Okay, TLT, we're looking at possibly doing, setting up for an iron condor on this. If world events go bad, then I would think bonds would become more valuable. So I'm looking at possibly a 20 delta on this. So I'm putting TLT in my 20 delta list for today. We'll see how that works out. And we got Tesla. I guess we're not going to get out all that early today. Still undecided on Tesla. And last but not least is Visa. And Visa not giving us any clear signals either. So that's it for today. Have a great weekend. Thanks for watching and happy trading.